says that the TV looks great. Over.
Okay, Roger, we're coming in.
Apollo 11 Houston, did you copy? Over.
Roger, we copied that, Charlie.
Roger, your transmissions the last couple of times have been about 2 by, over.
Okay, how do you read me now?
Roger, 5 by now.
Okay, we're zooming the lens on in to let, just about drill the monitor.
Roger.
Okay, it's in full zoom now.
Copy 11.
And how about the F-stop? Is 22 going to be adequate?
Stand by, we'll get with the Goldstone TV guy. We don't have anything here at Houston, stand by.
Yeah, that's right.
It looks good on the monitor as far as the F-stop goes, therefore we just assume it's okay, Goldstone.
Hello, Apollo 11 Houston. Goldstone says that TV looks really great. Bye-bye.
Okay, you just cut out, Charlie. We understand that it's looking great. We'll leave it the way it is and wait for you to come back on.
Roger, how do you read me now? Over.
Bye-bye.
Okay, my comments were from Goldstone that they see no white spots as we saw in 10. Looks like the AGC is working real well. The F-22 looks good. Over.
Okay, very good. Well, we shut out the sun coming in some of the other windows into the spacecraft, so it's looking through the number one window, and there isn't any reflected light right now, so it ought to be a pretty good picture.
Roger. Hello, Apollo 11 Houston, we'd like you to keep the TV on for about 10 minutes or so. So we can get some good comparison on the camera. You can do anything you're...
Apollo 11, over.
Roger, go ahead, over.
Charlie, I'm sorry, you keep cutting out. We heard up to you can do anything, and then after that, we didn't hear anything, and we knew that wasn't right anyhow, but we can't. But what do you want us to do?
Roger, we'll check the uplink on our voice. Our transmission on the TV was we'd like to get about at Goldstone, so we we can look at the camera quality back here at Houston for about 10 minutes or so when they patch it back into us. What we were saying was... we'd like a little... Stand by.
Start over with, we were saying...
Hey Houston, you suppose you could turn the earth a little bit so we could get a little bit more than just water?
Roger, 11. I don't think we got much control over that. Looks like you'll have to settle for the water. Houston, we're going to change, thinking about changing our voice uplink to another site. If you'll stand by, we'll see if we can improve the quality, over.
Okay, Charlie.
We'll stand by for your call.
Apollo 11 Houston, we'll try once more on this TV request. We'd like 10 minutes worth of TV, and we'd like a narrative if you could give us one on the exterior shots. You could we also suggest you might try the an interior position, over.
Roger, we're seeing the center of the Earth is viewed from the spacecraft in the eastern Pacific Ocean. We have not been able to visually pick up the Hawaiian island chain, but we can clearly see the western coast of North America, the United States, the San Joaquin Valley, the High Sierras, Baja California, and Mexico down as far as Acapulco and the Yucatan Peninsula, and you can see on through Central America to the northern coast of South America, Venezuela and Colombia. I'm not sure you'll be able to see all that on your screens down there.
Roger, Neil, we just wanted a narrative such that we can, when we get the playback, we can sort of correlate what we're seeing. Thank you very much.
I haven't seen anything but the disky so far.
Looks like they're hogging the windows.
You're right.
Apollo 11, Houston, on your cryos, we'd like at this time for you to place all four cryo heaters to auto and turn off all four cryo fans, over.
Okay, all four cryo heaters are auto. And all four cryo fans are off.
Roger, that's going to be your sleep configuration.
Okay.
And Buzz, we'll be terminating the battery charge in about a half an hour.
Roger.
Apollo 11 Houston, you can terminate TV at your convenience. We've got enough tape, and you can start PTC at your convenience. The rates look super for starting up, over.
Roger, Charlie.